Hey everybody, this video is going to be about how to say hello, hi, basically greetings in Arabic. And I made a blog post to go along with this on my blog at thearabicstudent.blogspot.com. And the greetings, there's various different ways to say hello in Arabic, like there is in any language. They have hello, they have good evening, good morning, all that stuff, all the basic stuff. But they have a few more that you won't really find in other languages. First of all, the first thing that I'm going to talk about is Assalamu alaikum. And this is basically means peace be upon you. And it's you plural, not just one person. Like you could never say Assalamu alayka or Assalamu alayki, meaning you one person. It's always you plural, assalamu alaikum, with kum on the end. It's more of a religious greeting, I guess, but you can say it even if you're not religious. You'll hear it a lot more during Ramadan than you will other times, but it's still pretty commonly used all the time. Whenever someone's giving a speech in a formal setting, they'll say assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. You put the last part, it's kind of hard to learn that whenever you're first starting out. The last part I said was wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. It means and the mercy and blessings of God. Wa rahmatullah. Rahma means mercy, barakat means blessings. And that's hard to say because it has the hard H, the ha. Rahma. You could say rahma and people will know what you're saying, but you're definitely not going to sound like an Arab, which is kind of the goal when you're learning another language, to pick up the accent. Wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. So it's assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. And I wrote all this out in the blog post, so if you go there you can see how it's written. And what else? Yeah, so assalamu alaikum. Notice that the as-salam, the seen, the s sound has more. You hold out on that longer than the other letters. You could say assalamu alaikum, but it doesn't sound as good as assalamu alaikum. They call it a shadda whenever you hold out a letter longer like that. You'll hear American Muslims say salam alaikum. That's what they're basically saying, assalamu alaikum. But they don't know Arabic, so they just say salam alaikum. The next greeting is ahlan wa sahlan. Ahlan wa sahlan is a less formal form of hello than assalamu alaikum. But it's widespread. You hear this all the time. Ahlan wa sahlan. You can respond with ahlain. Basically, that means two ahlans. But that's more found only in Lebanon, Syria, Jordan, Palestine, not really in Iraq and Saudi Arabia and the Khalij. But if you're in the Levant, you can say Ahlain as a response. Oh, and for Assalamu Alaikum, the response is Wa Alaikum Assalam. Basically, it means the same thing, and peace be upon you. So that's Assalamu Alaikum Wa Ahlan Wa Sahlan. The third greeting you can say is marhaban, marhaban. It's pretty much the closest thing they have to hi. Marhaban. You can also say marhabtain to reply to that, which means two marhabans. But again, that is only in the Levant. Marhaban, marhabtain. They have good morning. Sabah al-khair, sabah al-khair. Sabah means morning. Al-khair means the good. So literally it's translated as morning of the good, but just remember it as good morning. The response to sabah al-khair is sabah al-nur. Sabah al-nur. Somebody says to you sabah al-khair, you say sabah al-nur. You can also say sabah al-zift, but that's like an insult. It means the morning of the asphalt. If you're having a crappy morning, you can say sabah al-zift. But they might be offended if you say that. Only say that to your friends. They'll probably laugh. But if you say that to somebody who's like just not even an acquaintance, they'll probably get offended. So that's good morning, sabah al-khair, sabah al-nur. And good evening is masa al-khair, مساء الخير. مساء is evening, and again الخير is good, so evening of the good. And مساء النور is the response, just like with good morning. مساء النور means, مساء means evening, and النور means the light. So النور, the light. So literally it's evening of the light. So, but just remember it as the response to good evening. If somebody says مساء الخير, you respond with مساء النور. And the last one that I'm going to discuss is تحية لك. تحية لك. تحية means greetings, basically. Or greeting. One greeting. But in English, we would say greetings. And it's not very common, because just like it wouldn't be common in English to say greetings to you. You don't really say that too much. It's used somewhat, but not a whole lot. تحية لك. Yeah. So that's pretty much it. If you want more explanation on these greetings, just go to the blog, and I put the link in the sidebar. And good luck in learning Arabic. Thanks.